will surely heed me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Guard me as the apple of your eye. In the shadow of your wings, protect me. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours, and serve your majesty and sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Stay awake, for you do not know when the Son of Man Jesus said to his disciples, "Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Thus, I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, 'My master is delayed in coming,' and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants, to eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come at an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely, and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will, but did not make preparations nor act in accord with his will, shall be beaten severely. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Among us Marians, whenever we hear the scripture passage, we remember this particular priest who many, many years ago, I believe in a different province, I think in Poland, actually got up and proclaimed this passage saying, "You must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come," and then he fell over dead. And the comment in our album of the deceased said, "Thus proving the efficacy of his words." So it's one of those things that, are we prepared every day, every minute? Because we have to stay awake. And just like when you're driving, if you fall asleep just for a little moment, that can be life-threatening. How many times maybe have we had that experience of, or knowing someone that we're driving and all of a sudden there's just a fraction of a second in which all of a sudden we realize that we must have fallen asleep driving alone on one of those long highways that just doesn't ever change. And all of a sudden, just in that split second, we find ourselves in a different lane or we find ourselves moving this way. There's something that jolts us and we get back on course. And so the Lord wants to jolt us right now to say, are you falling asleep? Because we don't realize we fall asleep until we wake up and realize, wow, I'm going off the road right now. We don't want to be in that position. We want to preempt that by making sure that we get spiritual rest in order to stay awake. So the spiritual rest is resting in the Lord. And here, it's ultimately resting in his will, because you have this faithful and prudent steward. Because Peter's like, it kind of shocks him a little bit, and he's like, "Lord, is this meant for everyone, or are you talking to us right now?" And he says, this is what the faithful and prudent steward looks like. It's the one who's waiting. He knows what his master wants of him. He knows that his master has called him to be in charge of this particular property, and we can think of that in the terms of the Lord has called us to live in that kingly role of our baptism, which means to allow the Lord to rule over this part of his kingdom. And those that have been entrusted with us, and whatever our call, our responsibility, our vocations, that's the Lord's will for us. And then even in, I think it's in Thessalonians, where it says, rejoice, rejoice constantly. I forget all the words there, but thank the Lord. There's like this idea of rejoicing in God, praying constantly, giving thanks to God, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. So that's what it actually says in Scripture. So are we doing that? Now, here we have this servant who says, I know what my master wants of me, but I have time. I have space. He's not really going to know. So I can do my will. I can beat this person that I really, really don't like, this men servant and maid servant. Remember, this is another fellow servant. So he's someone that has been given a certain authority, but then he's misusing that authority. And he's beating those who are under him. He's eating, he's drinking, he's getting drunk. He's becoming slower in that. Just like when you eat a big meal, what happens? Food coma. When you eat a big meal and you drink and get drunk, it's a double whammy and you just start really, really falling asleep. So imagine you're trying to drive. So going back to that whole thing of being on the highway of your life, and you're just allowing all these things to come in that just make you fall asleep. And especially the getting drunk aspect, it's not merely just a food coma, but it's something that is even more powerful that puts you down and you're not able to really wake up. Whereas maybe with the area of eating or just tired, you wake up like this. But if you're drunk, you go down and you don't get up. And so the Lord is saying here, what are you putting within you? What are you eating? And most importantly, what are you drinking? Are these things allowing you to find a rest that makes sure that you're awake on the highway of life? Or are there things that are coming into your life? If there's habits of the mind, if there's habits of the heart, if there's habits of the body, that are making you fall asleep and you don't even realize it. Because the master is going to come at an hour you don't expect. If you're not taking the time to be rested before the journey, when you're in the midst of that driving, you're going to fall asleep and you won't know. And so we need to stay awake by saying, what am I putting into my life right now? What am I allowing to nourish me? Where's my nap before the journey? That's not a falling asleep when you don't expect, but it's a resting in the Lord. And notice that there's even these degrees of this. And again, we can go back to this idea of eating, you can fall into a food coma. Drinking and getting drunk, you fall into something far more deadly. So in the same way, the servant who knew his master's will, but he didn't make preparations nor act in accord with his will, shall be beaten severely. So this is a servant who said, I know what I'm supposed to be doing. And yet he says, no. Do you see how even St. Faustina would talk about this image of, Lord, let me not commit even the slightest voluntary offense. It says, yes, there are involuntary offenses that are there. All of us do those. But the thing that hurts the Lord's heart is when we have a voluntary offense in which we say, I know what I should be doing, but I choose to not do it. Because I want my way. I want my own will. And then we have this other person, the servant who is ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten only lightly. So again, there's a difference between someone who is struggling and maybe doesn't know exactly what they're supposed to be doing, and yet they're still doing the wrong thing. God takes that into account. They're beaten only so lightly. There's still a punishment there. We can think of that almost as purgatory in a sense. There's still a healing that needs to happen that's different than someone who says, I know what I'm supposed to do, and I don't care. There's someone who's like, I think I'm supposed to do this or this, and they go off the road, but that's a little more forgivable. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much. So if someone knows what they're supposed to do, they know that the Lord is saying, this is your call. And especially those of us who are living with the Lord, growing in this life of the Spirit, He's already moving within our hearts, in which we know what we're supposed to do. We know that we're supposed to give thanks to God. We know that we're supposed to rejoice even in the midst of sufferings. We know that we're supposed to constantly give our hearts to the Lord. And yet when we say no thanks, then we're actually going against His will. We're not being the servant who is truly living out His stewardship. So let's ask the Lord. It's a sobering, but it should be sobering, but not scary. Sobering in the sense of, wake us up to say, wow, what is the Lord calling me to? And then to know that the Lord gives us the courage to do it, but we have to be wise in what we put into our mind, our heart, and our body. When one of them is off, that's when things start to break down. If you're not allowing your body to seek the Lord's will, and it goes off through the wounding of emotions, then the mind can follow that, the heart can follow that. If the mind gets confused and starts putting in different ideas or habits of thought, saying, this is what I want, well, then the body will follow that. And if the heart, the place in which we choose to follow God or not, we say no, well, then our mind and our body are going to follow that as well. So all of them work together in different ways. And sin ultimately goes in and breaks them apart. And so what the Lord wants is He wants to restore us back to that new image of man found in Christ. Christ, the mind of Christ, the heart of Christ, and being able to live in this bodily existence in allowing our emotions, our desires, all of those to ultimately be fulfilled in the Lord Jesus Christ. That's His will for us. So let's ask the Lord, Lord, heal me in those areas in which one of those three is going in one different direction. Lord, heal them. Bring them into wholeness. Bring them into integrity so that I can truly do what I'm being called to and not fall asleep on the road. We bring our prayers and petitions to Him today. For Pope Francis and all bishops, may God grant them strength and courage as they continue preaching the truth of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For government officials across the world, may God's mercy be on them and those they serve. Let us pray to the Lord. For those burdened by the pressures of anxiety, may Jesus bless them with His peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those in this community struggling with their faith, may the Holy Spirit provide wisdom and understanding necessary to find their way. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the recently deceased, may they rest in Jesus' arms for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the intention of this Mass for all unborn children. We pray that they might be protected in their mother's womb. We also pray that our country and world might recognize the dignity and right to their lives and their protection. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the intention of our Holy Father for this month, which is that by the virtue of baptism, the laity, especially women, may participate more in areas of responsibility in the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions within Our Lady's intercessory box, for all those prayers that are within the silence of your hearts, we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. grant our prayers and petitions. Through your Son, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, whom we made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts of prayer, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have called us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope and Ronald our Bishop and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To rescue their souls from death and to keep them alive in famine. may be helped by what you give in this present age, and prepare for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. Be thou, Prince of the